Hello students, today we will have the online chemistry class for class 10 and I will start with the chapter 8 hydrogen chloride study of compounds. This is a very important chapter for your board exam and in this chapter we are going to study about the preparation of hydrogen chloride gas and hydrochloric acid, the physical properties of hydrogen chloride gas and hydrochloric acid and their chemical reactions and uses. As we know, due to COVID-19, we cannot have the regular classes like every year. So this year we are taking the help of these online classes to conduct the class and I hope this will help you in your studies. Till then I will advise all my students to stay home and to stay safe. See, we know that hydrogen chloride gas is a polar covalent compound. Generally, the electronic configuration of hydrogen is 1 and chlorine is 287. So, both the atoms need one each electron to attain the octet. So, hence they share one each electron with each other to undergo a covalent bond. Why the term polar? Among hydrogen and chlorine, the electronegativity of chlorine is higher than that of the hydrogen. What is electronegativity? The tendency to attract shared pair of electron towards itself. So, the electronegativity of chlorine being greater, it attracts the shared pair of electron towards itself, giving rise to a partial negative charge on chlorine and partial positive charge on hydrogen. And this generates a polarity in the compound. Generally, hydrogen chloride gas can be prepared by mixing hydrogen and chlorine in presence of sunlight, where H nu represents sunlight. This reaction takes place best at diffused sunlight because on direct sunlight the reaction becomes explosive and in dark the reaction is negligible. I will come to the laboratory preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. You see the setup. Here in a round bottom flask we are taking NaCl and we are pouring concentrated sulfuric acid through this thistle funnel and we are applying heat from below. So, on the combination of concentrated sulfuric acid and NaCl, in presence of heat, the reaction takes place and produces hydrogen chloride gas which comes through this pipe and it is dried over concentrated sulfuric acid. We are drying hydrogen chloride gas in concentrated sulfuric acid. After drying the gas, again the gas comes out by this pipe and it is collected here by air. So this is our complete setup for the preparation of hydrogen chloride gas. For this, the reaction is what? NaCl plus H2SO4 concentrated. And if we use the heat can be on two range. One is above 200 degree centigrade and another NaCl plus H2SO4 concentrated and the heat is below 200 degree centigrade. So when the heat is above 200 degree centigrade we get the salt Na2SO4 plus HCl. And if the heat is below 200 degree centigrade, we get the salt NaHSO4 plus HCl. So, as we know that sulfuric acid is a dibasic acid, it can produce two types of salt. One is Na2SO4 and another is NaHSO4. If we use the heat above 200, the salt is Na2SO4. And if we use the heat below 200, the salt is NaHSO4. Now, this is the more preferable process for the lab preparation, the below 200 one. Why? Because if we use above 200 degree centigrade, Na2SO4 is produced. Now, Na2SO4 is a very sticky substance and it sticks to the glass apparatus and becomes very difficult to remove. So, we avoid the production of Na2SO4. Moreover, whenever we are using excess heat, there may be wastage of fuel also and the glass apparatus may crack down. So in general we avoid the temperature above 200 degree centigrade and for the lab we prefer below 200 degree centigrade temperature. Now, one by one, why I take NaCl as the lab reagent? Because NaCl is very cheap and easily available salt. Why we use concentrated H2SO4? Why not other acids like nitric acid? See, when we are preparing hydrogen chloride gas, we always prefer an acid which is non-volatile. Concentrated sulfuric acid is a non-volatile acid. What do you mean by the term volatile? Volatile means any substance which easily evaporates. Nitric acid is an acid which easily evaporates if kept free. So if I use here nitric acid, then along with this hydrogen chloride vapor, the nitric acid vapor will get mixed. And hence, we will get a mixture of nitric acid and hydrogen chloride gas. So we don't use any volatile acid, that's why nitric acid is not used in this preparation. And as sulfuric acid is a non-volatile acid, we use sulfuric acid. Next, by this reaction, as hydrogen chloride gas is produced, it is dried over concentrated sulfuric acid. Now, why concentrated sulfuric acid and why not other drying agents like P2O5 or CaO? Phosphorus pentoxide and quick limes are very good drying agents. But still, these two drying agents are not used. Why? Because these two drying agents, being basic in nature, reacts with hydrogen chloride. So if I use CaO, it will react with HCl and produce CaCl2 plus H2O, defeating the purpose of collecting hydrogen chloride gas. Same for P2O5. If I use P2O5, it will react with HCl and produce POCl3 plus 3HPO3. Again, defeating the purpose of drying it. So, in both the cases, they react with hydrogen chloride gas. And hence, if a question comes that why the other drying agents are not used, you have to write that because they react with P2O5 or CaO, and along with this, you have to give the reactions. Please remember to give the reactions in your answer. Next comes the collection of the hydrogen chloride gas, where it is collected by air. Why by air and not by any other reagents like water? Generally, we collect all the gases either by air or by water. Here, why it is not collected by water? Because hydrogen chloride gas is a highly soluble in water gas. So if I collect it by water, it will not at all be collected and all the gas will get dissolved in water. So it is collected by air. How? By upward displacement of air. I repeat, it is collected by upward displacement of air. Why by upward displacement of air? Because it is heavier than air. The heavier gases are collected by upward displacement and the lighter gases are collected by downward displacement. Next, identification of hydrogen chloride gas. Hydrogen chloride gas can be identified by two processes. Number one, whenever hydrogen chloride gas is reacted with ammonium hydroxide, we get dense white fumes of ammonium chloride. How we do? I have already showed you this experiment in the lab. Suppose we are doing a reaction, performing a reaction where hydrogen chloride gas will be producing. So before starting the reaction, we will dip a glass rod in NH4OH and we will bring it near the mouth of the test tube. So we will see instantly dense white fumes of NH4Cl is coming out, and this is the identification test of hydrogen chloride gas. Another is that wherever hydrogen chloride gas will be passed through a silver nitrate solution, it will give a white precipitate of silver chloride. Whenever hydrogen chloride gas is passed through silver nitrate solution, it will give a white precipitate of silver chloride along with the production of HNO3. Next, we will read about the fountain experiment in this chapter. Why we will read about this experiment? This experiment shows that HCl gas is highly soluble in water. To demonstrate the great solubility of the gas in water, we will perform the fountain experiment. Now see what we will take in the fountain experiment. We will take a round bottom flask, and the flask is full of HCl gas. The flask is filled with HCl gas. Now, in the flask, we have inserted two pipe-like things. One is a dropper. The small one is a dropper filled with water. Inside the dropper, there is water. And another is the jet tube, which is dipped in a blue litmus solution. So I repeat what I have taken. I have taken a round bottom flask filled with HCl gas, and inside the flask I have connected a dropper which is filled with water and a jet tube which is dipped in a blue litmus solution. Now what I will do, I will press this dropper. As I press the dropper, all the water inside the dropper goes inside this jar. Now HCl gas being highly soluble in water, the maximum amount of the gas that can get dissolved in the given amount of water in the dropper get dissolved in it and produces a saturated solution. Now as a large amount of gas get dissolved in the water, the pressure inside the round bottom flask drops suddenly. And to adjust the pressure inside the jar and outside, forcefully through the jet tube, the blue litmus comes inside, and as a fountain, it falls here. And the color of the fountain becomes red. And we can see here, red fountain. Now you see, as HCl gas is dissolving in water and producing inside hydrochloric acid, we also can understand the acidic nature of the gas. Thus the gas doesn't show any acidic property when it is in the gaseous state, but it does show the acidic property when it is dissolved in water. As we are pressing water and it is getting dissolved in water and showing the acidic property, due to the acidic property, the blue litmus becomes red in color, and inside the round bottom flask we can observe a red color fountain. So it demonstrates two things. One, solubility of HCl in water, and two, acidic nature of the gas, acidic nature of the gas when dissolved in water. Now based on this point, I will explain why HCl gas is not showing any acidic property, not conducting electricity when it is in the gaseous state, but it shows acidic property and conducts electricity when it is dissolved in water. Why? Because HCl is a polar covalent compound. Now you see, the acidic property is shown by those substances which produces H plus ions in the solution. So whenever in any solution there will be the presence of H plus ions, that particular solution will show the acidic property. Now HCl in the gaseous state is in the combined form as H bond Cl, and in this case there is no free H plus ions, hence it doesn't show any acidic property. Again, same for the conduction of electricity. Those solutions only conduct electricity where there is the presence of free ions. In gaseous state, HCl doesn't produce any free ions, so it doesn't conduct electricity. But when we dissolve HCl in water, it dissociates producing H3O plus plus Cl minus ions. Due to the formation of ions, it conducts electricity, and due to the presence of H3O plus, it shows the acidic property. And why it breaks down in water? Because the compound is a polar covalent compound. Generally, non-polar covalent compound do not get dissolved in water producing the ions. HCl being a polar covalent compound get dissolved in water and produce ions. Hence, it shows acidic property and conduct electricity in the liquid state. Hydrogen chloride gas is neither a supporter of combustion nor a combustible gas. Apart from that, hydrogen chloride gas generally reacts with metal to produce the metallic chloride, that is salt, plus hydrogen gas. So any metal, suppose Na, will react with hydrogen chloride gas to produce NaCl plus H2. So these reactions, it will show And generally, hydrogen chloride gas also combines with another gas, ammonia, two gases to produce a white color solid, ammonium chloride. So this is an example of two gas reacts to produce a solid, where ammonia and hydrogen chloride at the two gaseous state and ammonium chloride is in the solid state. So this is all about the hydrogen chloride gas. In the next class, we will continue to read about the hydrochloric acid, which we will obtain by dissolving hydrogen chloride gas in water, and there we will read about the preparation of hydrochloric acid from hydrogen chloride gas and its chemical reactions. In this class, up to this much, and based on this class, I will give you some questions to as homework that you can solve at home.